لخلوف فم الصائم أطيب عند الله يوم القيامة من ريح المسك. Agreed upon that when some believer is fasting, the smell of his mouth is more beloved to Allah on the day of judgment than the smell of musk. Okay, Allah can turn anything into anything. Yani the whatever ugly smell to him, he can turn it into the best smell. So Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala encourages the fasting. So he says that, and also that shows if one of the effects of fasting is that much love to Allah, so how about fasting itself? It's even much more beloved to Allah. That's why the reward for fasting is unlimited, as the Prophet ﷺ mentioned. Okay, Anas radiallahu anhu said, some of the companions of the Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam wanted to make wudu. So the Messenger sallallahu alaihi wasallam said, any one of you has water, he brought the pot with water and he put his hand in it and he said, make wudu by the name of Allah. So I was seeing the water coming from between his fingers, like until all of them made wudu from that pot. So I said to Anas, how many do you think they were? He said, around 70. But this is special for the Prophet ﷺ, that his hand is blessed. Okay. And we mentioned in some of the classes of Aqeedah, why did Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make the prophets blessed by their bodies, okay, to increase their faith, the faith of their followers, because they are the foundation of their nation. So if they see all those things, their faith becomes much, much stronger. And that motivates them to be the best amongst this nation and to be the role model, you see. Just like what happened to Jesus, just like what happened to Moses, just like what happened to Abraham. He was thrown in the fire, okay? So these kinds of blessings are just some of the miracles that were happening. And many, many things like this happened to the Prophet ﷺ. Many things. One time they were on a travel to a battle, and they had no food. Everything is finished because it was too long. The battle was too long. It took them a long time. So the Prophet ﷺ said, gather whatever you have. Any remains of anything, just bring them here. So one brought a piece of, dry bread, and the other brought something else. And they put it on something, some kind of sheet or something. And the Prophet ﷺ rubbed over it, and he made some supplication, and the whole army ate from it, and still they took carry on for the way. Okay, carry on for the way. All of them, the whole army, they got full at that time, and then they put in their bags or whatever the carry on. Abdullah ibn Zayd said, describing the wudu of the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam, he said that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wasallam ordered some water and he poured some on his hand, washed them three times. And by hand here we don't mean all the hand, because when you wash your hands in the beginning, you just wash the palms, not all the hand. The hand is this, from here, from the tip of your hand fingers, to up to and including the elbows. Up to and including the elbows. This is the hand. Okay? So, the Prophet ﷺ when he started the wudu, he only washed the palms, three times, okay, which is recommended, okay. And then he took them out of the pot, and he took the hand with some water and he rinsed his mouth with it and put some in his nose. And then it's one action actually. Yani, there is a hadith, a weak hadith, which makes them three actions, but actually it's only one action, as in the true hadith. You take water, you do this, and then one action. Okay, that's it. Huh? That's it. One action. Enough. Okay. If you do it three times, that's better. Two times or three times, that's better.
Four.
Don't exceed three, because the Prophet ﷺ never exceeded three. Okay? You can be sufficient with one time, if you want. Then he washed his face three times. The face from ear to ear here, and from the beginning of the hair, where the hair normally comes, okay? Yani, if you are bald like me, you don't start from here, okay, where the baldness is. No, you start where normally the hair starts, okay?
The forehead.
Yeah, and until the chin, under the chin, yani, or the lower part of the chin. And if you have a beard, then you must wash over the beard. Okay? Washing inside the beard is not an obligation, but you can do it if you want.
Okay.
But above the beard, like this, only this, not the neck here. No, this is not the part of the wudu. Okay? So you do it from here to here and from the edge of this ear until the edge of this ear. The ears are part of the head, not the face. Okay. Then he put some water in his hand and he washed his right hand, then his left hand, twice and twice. Even though he started his face three times, but he washed his hands here two times and two times. So it's okay to mix up. Yani, it's not necessary if you start washing your face three times that your hands also three times or your foot also three times. No. And then he took his hand with some water and he rubbed over his head. He started from the beginning like this. He went back all the way and then he came back again. This is one rubbing. This is the full and the best. To start from here, go back all the way and then come back. And then to finish the job of the head, you rub inside the ears and outside the ears. That would be the head, okay? And then washed his foot. And washing the foot is again including the ankles, not up to the ankles, including the ankles. And if you go up more, better. Not recommend, not obligatory, but better. Just like the hands, you go more, it's better. Similarly, when you wash your feet, you must include the ankles, and if you go further up, that's recommended, not obligatory. Okay. Abu Hurairah radiallahu anhu narrated that the Messenger sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, when one of you wakes up from his night sleep, Let him not immerse his hand in the pot until he washes it three times, because he doesn't know where his hand slipped. Mm-hmm. Agreed upon. Okay. Meaning, while you are asleep, you are almost unconscious, so you might wander with your hand everywhere of your body, right? So when you wake up, to be sure and to be careful, first wash your hands, yeah, then go on with your wudu, okay? Rufa'ah ibn Rafi' radiallahu anhu said, the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam said, the salat of one of you is not perfect until he completes the wudu as Allah ordered him, and then he explained how the wudu is. So one should not take it light. Wudu is a necessary condition for the prayer acceptance, and the prayer's acceptance is a necessary condition for all your other actions. No action will be considered or looked into on the Day of Judgment without your prayers being complete. So prayers have a special position in Islam. That's why Allah always, in Quran, when He mentions the obligations, He starts with the prayers. Okay. Talha ibn Musarrif narrated about his father, who narrated about his grandfather. He said, I came to the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam while he was making wudu. While I saw him, I saw a lot of water on his face and his beard and his chest, and I saw him separating between washing the mouth and rinsing the nose. This is a weak hadith. The author brought it to warn against it, that the true thing is to be moderate when you wash your face and not to spill everything all over, okay, because it's not necessary. And also that washing the mouth and the nose is one action. Okay? So if someone brings you this hadith, this is weak. Okay? Tell him no. This is a weak hadith. You cannot act upon weak hadiths. Even if he tells you it's better, no, it's not better. Better is what the Prophet ﷺ said, what he did. Okay? But this is not a true hadith, so you don't act upon it. And you find a lot of people like this. Yani when they finish the wudu, it's like they have been almost in a war with someone with water, water guns, wet and all that. You don't have to do that. First of all, pour the water very moderately, as moderately as you can.
Don't waste the water.
Don't waste, because waste is in wudu is forbidden. The Prophet ﷺ said, "Don't waste in wudu." And wudu, you do it many times, so when you remember this fact, don't waste, don't waste, don't waste, don't waste, don't waste, 5 times, 6 times a day, that will program you not to waste, you see? That's the beauty of it. So you don't have to pour a lot of water, and you don't have to take a lot of water for your face or for... No, just a little bit, yeah. Enough to wet your face and to rub over. That's it. Okay. Shaqiq ibn Salama radiallahu anhu said, I saw Ali radiallahu anhu, Uthman radiallahu anhu, while they make wudu, they were doing 3 times for each part of wudu. Okay. This is one way, three times. You can do it two, you can do it one, you can make a mixture, wash your face three times, your hands two times, your face two times, your hands three times, yani, no problem. You can be sufficient with one time only. But rubbing over the head is never more than one time. Okay, there is also a weak hadith about rubbing three times. There is a weak hadith about rubbing the neck. So all those you should be aware from. Weak. Stay away from them. Okay? Yeah. If you want it because you feel that there's a sweat on your neck or something and you wanted to clean it up, that's okay, but it's not part of the worship itself, not part of the wudu.
Feeling clean.
Yeah, feeling clean, whatever you want to do. You can clean under your underarm also, whatever you want. Yeah, no one
so
says.
So rubbing over the head is only one time?
One time. Nah.
It's good, that's clear.
Yes. Unfortunately, a lot of Muslims who are born in Islam, who lived for 60 years as Muslims, and yet when you see their wudu, you know, you shake your head, you say, have they become Muslims now? You know, 60 years, and that's their wudu? Not only wudu, even prayer. One of the companions, Hudhayfa radiallahu anh, saw a man making prayer, and he was not praying with settling down, yani, taking things one at a time, calmly and easily, as he should, yani, in the prayer. He was not giving the time for ruku' or sujood. Hudhayfa said, for how long you've been doing this? He said, for 40 years. He said, by Allah, if you die on this, you will not die as a Muslim. Because you have not prayed. You see. Yani, prayers has pillars and has obligations and has recommendations, sunnah. The pillars, if you miss, your prayer is invalid altogether. The obligations, if you miss, the reward is short. Okay. But this guy was missing on a pillar, you see, to remain in ruku' for a certain time, to remain in sujood for a certain time, to remain after ruku' and between the two prostrations. So a lot of people don't do this. Yani, when they pray with congregation, they have to do it. But look at them when they pray themselves. Or if they miss the congregation prayer, they come late. And then when they finish up, look at them how they pray. You'll be surprised. You know? So, this is regarding this hadith about perfecting the wudu. Okay, this hadith regarding washing between the fingers, the Prophet ﷺ said, وَخَلِّلْ بَيْنَ الْأَصَابِعِ. And this goes true for both fingers, the foot and the hands. Yani, in wudu, the hand includes in between the fingers, and the foot include in between the fingers. Okay? And also, when you wash your mouth and rinse your nose, you should do it strongly, or not any meaning strongly, but you should make sure that you have done enough of it. Yani. Except if you are fasting, then don't put too much water in your mouth because some of it might go down your throat. Okay? Yeah. Whether from your mouth or from your nose sometimes. Uthman radiallahu anhu said the Prophet ﷺ made wudu three times, narrated by a Muslim. This is one form. A awake hadith that the Prophet ﷺ rubbed over his head three times. This is a weak hadith, okay? Another weak hadith, the Prophet ﷺ took water for his ears, took different water than he took for rubbing over his head to rub his ears. This is a weak hadith. Because the head and the ears are one part. It's all the head. Okay, the Prophet ﷺ said in a true hadith, Al-udhunani min al-ra's. Ears are from the head. Okay. So therefore, you rub over your head, and the same water that you use to rub over your head, you clean your ears with. You don't have to take a new water. If you want, go ahead, take. But it's not something which is either recommended or obligatory. So this is a weak hadith that he took new water for his ears. A lot of weak hadiths are floating, so one has to be careful, yani. Hadith Uthman radiallahu anhu, the Prophet ﷺ was washing inside his beard, like this. This is recommended, not an obligation, but it's recommended. Okay, so this pretty much, inshallah, covers the wudu. Of course, there is a dua after wudu. When finishes the wudu, he says, "Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, wahdahu la sharika lah." He says, "La ilaha illallah, wahdahu la sharika lah." وهو على كل شيء قدير اللهم اجعلني من التوابين واجعلني من المتطهرين يعني after he says there is no one worthy of being worshipped but Allah then he says oh Allah make me amongst those who constantly repent and constantly purify themselves constantly repent and constantly purify yourself Okay. لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له له الملك وله الحمد وهو على كل شيء قدير اللهم اجعلني من التوابين توابين repenters واجعلني من المتطهرين the ones who purify themselves enough or should I repeat
I lost it the whole way
you can find it in a book upstairs
I will
all of it they have a nice book
like his brother is pretty good with the writing in Arabic
ما شاء الله Okay, so any question about wudu, brothers? I'm sorry, brothers. The dua starts as I started it, as I said it in the beginning. First, you say, Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh. And then you say, Allahumma ij'alni min at-tawwabin wa ij'alni min at-tahirin. Okay. Ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, wa ashhadu anna Muhammadan abduhu wa rasuluh. This is narrated by Muslims.
Abdu means servant?
Yeah, servant, slave.
Abdu.
No.
Sorry?
The author brought a dua, a long dua during wudu, but it's weak, so avoid it. During wudu, you find a lot of people are murmuring or something, you know, or something saying that it has no basis.
Astaghfirullah and all that.
Yeah, whatever they say, there has no base. It has no basis. Mm-hmm. Yeah. Sure. It's weak, huh?
Can I say, أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له وأشهد أن محمد عبده ورسوله اللهم اجعلني من التوابين
This is an addition in another narration. اللهم اجعلني من التوابين واجعلني من الطهر.
Extra?
Yeah, extra. But أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله. Yeah. Any question about wudu, brothers? Anything that needs to be clarified? Yes?
Sure, while we are fasting, we use siwak. This is, how about this
one? Huh?
While we are fasting, we use siwak.
Yeah, that's okay. You can use siwak, but be careful with the taste. يعني the paste don't put too much or يعني don't يعني become careless because it might go down, you know. So you be careful, otherwise it's okay, inshallah.
If you use with toothpaste.
Yeah, I'm saying that. يعني don't put too much. يعني be careful not to let it go down. Okay, that's all.
The nose, mouth, ears, and face, you do three times. It's just the top and back of the head.
No, ears are from the head, not from the face.
Okay.
Ears,
so
you rub once.
This part of the head?
Yeah, once.
Once, okay.
The other, the face, you can do it three times, you can do it two, you can do it one. Okay, but the ear is only, the head and ear are only one, rubbing.
But is it compulsory for somebody who is fasting to be using siwak?
Not compulsory, no. But it's okay. It's okay.
Or if it doesn't use, huh? If it doesn't use
siwak is never compulsory, you know. It's recommended. It's highly recommended, you see. يعني cleaning the mouth. By siwak I mean cleaning the mouth, cleaning the teeth. Okay, this is highly recommended in Islam. Yeah. And the Prophet ﷺ used to do it not only at every wudu, but every time he comes in, every time he goes, يعني he meets with some people. So he was very careful with this.
Because I normally hear from some who normally says that he who fasts, the odor of his mouth is like al-misk in front of Almighty Allah.
That's by Allah.
Is it hadith?
That's
of
by Allah. It doesn't mean that when you are fasting, you sit to next to your brother Muhammad, and you say, oh, "Smell, brother, it's like misk." No, he would say, "What?" يعني smell the breath smells bad even if you are full. So how about when your stomach is empty, then it's, you know, more ugly, okay? Yes. Yeah.
Sure, but I asked Sheikh in Cambodia, he said that we shouldn't use toothpaste, he said that.
Yeah, there are madhabs. There are yani scholars who say you should not use the paste. There are scholars who say don't use anything, even the brush. But no proof for that. يعني there is no proof that the Prophet ﷺ forbade us from cleaning the mouth.